to Fat Chicho. Fixing, what's wrong with radio?
Hi, we'll be back to our panel discussion on heart problems in the angina monologues in just a second.
Wow. Angina. I'm not even sure what that word means.
You know what? You would if you'd gone to college.
Well, I quit high school halfway through to serve my troops in Grenada.
Yeah, that's a good excuse.
I didn't fight, I just served my troops.
Yeah, I know. Because you didn't have a college education.
That's right. We put 50 songs about college life onto 50 CDs.
How many CDs is that a song?
Well, that's...
It's a good thing you're an actor.
Hey, Colin.
Yeah?
What comes to mind when I say Ricky Ricardo and great cigars?
Oh, tapioca.
Really? Why's that?
Wasn't that his big song? Oh. Tapioca! Tapioca!
No, Colin. I'm talking about you. I'm talking about cubicle.
Cuba. That's a small island.
It is. What do you tell the people about it?
Leave Cuba behind for a second. Let's go to another island.
All right.
An island where some of my favorite music can be found.
Oh.
Ska.
Oh, ska.
Yeah.
Like a bunch of crows.
Ska! Tapioca! No. Ska. And who can forget that great ska college hit? Ra, ra, ra. Ska, ra, ra.
Welcome back to Al TV. Right now it's time for our exclusive interview with Mr. Marshall Mathers, also known as Eminem, also known as The Real Slim Shady, also known as Missy Misdemeanor Elliot. We'll follow his startling transformation from hardcore ALF fan to hardcore rapper. This is indeed a pleasure. Marshall, welcome to Al TV. I'm sorry, should I call you Marshall or Missy?
Marshall, you know what I'm saying?
Well, Marshall it is then. Hope it wasn't out of line to ask.
No, it wasn't. You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying. Because, you know, I wouldn't want you to be offended.
And I'm not. You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, I do.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes. Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes!
You know what I'm saying?
Yes,
you know what I'm saying?
I told you!
You know what I'm saying?
Look,
you know what I'm saying?
I said
you know
that
what
I...
You know what I'm saying?
I said
you know what I'm saying?
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
Look. If you had one shot to sit on your lazy butt and watch all the TV you ever wanted until your brain turned to mush, would you go for it? Or just let it slip.
Yo.
Remote is ready. Eyes wide, palms are sweaty. The Flintstones on the TV already. Wilma and Betty. No virgin. The channel surfing and I'm HD ready. So I flip. Garbage is all I'm getting. The Simon Cowell who folks want to disembowel. He opens his mouth, always says something foul. They're dying, wow. Wannabes are crying now. He votes them out. Time to throw in the towel. Shows based on reality. Oh, the humanity. Oh. Aussie's family show loves profanity. Whoa, the insanity. Oh, dogs that crap and be home of depravity. No, they live happily. Yo, plus the Ally G show and celebrity mole. Oh, and there's Anna Nicole. She's scaring me. Look, mono cavities. Oh, it's a station break. Better go out to the kitchen and microwave something.
You're gonna lose your mind watching TV. They told me, they told me, but I'm still tuning every show. My cable gets C-SPAN TV Land and HBO. The Travel Channel, Discovery, and Lifetime.
You're gonna lose your mind watching TV.
I watch NASCAR racing. That show about undertaking Larry King to 24 to Blind Order. The Weather Channel's boring, like 60 Minutes, Ancient Reporters. Next up on E! True Hollywood Story, the rise and decline of 12 actors named Corey. Shows for next fall, they already been naming. CSI Boise and Touched by an Uncle both sound pretty layman. So does everybody tolerates Raymond. And King of Queens jumped the shark the first minute. I can't believe Richard Simmons ain't in it. I move right on the way, simple rules for dating my teenage daughter. Then I bet I watch The Bachelorette, followed by Welcome Back, Cotter, and The Muppet Show, where they go, and I'm
not gonna lose your mind watching TV. They told me, they told me, but I still tune in every show. My cable gets C-SPAN, TV Land, and HBO, the Disney Channel, and A&E, and Lifetime.
You're gonna
lose your mind watching TV. They told me, cajoled me, but I still love Lisa Kudrow. I'm looking at C-SPAN, TV Land, and HBO, the Playboy Channel, and Court TV, and Lifetime.
Never miss Melrose Place or Lost in Space. I've seen each amazing race and without a trace. But I only watched Will and Grace one time, one day. Wish I hadn't, cause TiVo now thinks I'm gay. Oh, and Fear Factor, I watched maybe a half hour. After that, felt like I needed a long shower. Network execs with naked ambitions. Next week on Fox, watch Lions Eat Christians. Like to tie up those programming planners. Make them watch all of that junk till their heads explode just like scanners. Covered grub-eating fools on Survivor. Look, there's James Lipton discussing the oeuvre of Mr. Rob Schneider, and there's Gilligan and SpongeBob Plus. There's MacGyver, and Jay Leno has got Madonna. Hey, there's Luke Perry on a special all-pig Latin episode of Drew Carey. Wanna turn on E.T., cause I'm a gossip freak, and I gotta know who J-Lo is marrying this week. A 30-second spot, then we come back to Are You Hot? I was planning on recording The Sopranos. I forgot! I love shows with or without a plot. I'll stare till my legs are numb, shot, because I only have got one brain to rot. I'm gonna spend my life watching television a lot.
You're gonna
lose your mind watching TV. They told me, they told me, but I still tune in every show. My cable gets C-SPAN, TV Land, and HBO, the Sci-Fi Channel, and AMC, and Lifetime.
You're gonna
lose your mind watching TV. They told me, cajoled me, turn off that Oprah Winfrey show. I got it on C-SPAN, TV Land, and HBO, the Learning Channel, and MTV, and Lifetime.
You're gonna
watch anything you want to, man.
Thank you.
Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a fateful trip that started from this tropic point aboard this tiny ship. The mate was a mighty sailor man, skipper brave and sure. High passengers set sail that day for a 3-hour tour, a 3-hour tour. The weather started getting rough, the tiny ship was tossed. If not for the courage of a fearless crew, the middle would be lost. The middle would be lost. The ship set ground on the shore of this uncharted desert isle, with Gilligan, the skipper too, a millionaire and his wife, a movie star, the professor and